why this topic was when I moved into from my college. In college, whenever we used to talk, we used to talk crap. And we knew that even the teacher won't understand, and we didn't care. Because we used to get some marks, that's it. But once I came into the industry, I found that what you talk is very, very important. Because at the end of the day, you want your manager, higher up people, to know what you're doing. This is not only limited if you're talking, if you're in an industry. Say, for example, you're starting your own startup or something. And you're going to present your idea to your, say for example, to your investors. So, and investors know shit about technology, believe me. Okay, they know nothing. Okay, what at the end of the day, what they want to know? How many people are going to buy this? How much money you are going to get out of this? Okay, so if you tell them, okay, I run this algorithm, I get this done, he's going to say, so? He's going to say, like, I'll pay some money and I'll get other people to do the same thing. Right. So, and tell me honestly, when you have some person who you need to present to and you know that guy is not understanding a goddamn thing of your saying, how many of you guys, one sec, how many of you guys felt like doing something like this? You like open his head up and find what is inside, man, what makes this guy tick? Exactly, right? Yeah. But believe me, that's not how it works. Okay, because at the end of the day, this guy is also important, and that guy is also important. Obviously, that guy being you.
Exactly,
exactly, right? Yeah. So, just to start off, my name is Avradi Bhattacharya. I work in Texas Instruments. I work in what is called as system admin over there. My major vendors are Hitachi Data Systems. I work with them in the storage infrastructure. I won't go down into the technical details because that is not the topic today. When I say storage admin, I don't mean this. I do not mean this. When I say storage admin, I mean I do this.
Wow.
Nice, right? Yeah. Believe me, it's very cold inside. Yeah. And if say, for example, if you get stuck inside for 9 hours, you're not going to forget that day. Okay? So, yeah. Coming back to the main point of the discussion, right? All of you know this guy. All of you know. All of you know this guy too, right? Yes, okay. Who knows this guy? Most of you know, right? And you also know this guy. So what was the standing out factor among all of these guys? Because whatever the ideas they had, I could say like 1,000 other people also had the same idea. What was the standing out feature among them? Can any one of you? Yeah, because you'll have intelligent guys here in India too, right? And I could bet at the same time they would have made the same sales pitch, but no one recognized. Exactly. What they could say, they would recognize the audience. Okay, this guy understands shit, I'm going to give shit to him. Okay, this guy understands technology, I'm going to sell him technology. Believe me when I say these guys are so good marketers, so good sellers, they could sell a refrigerator to an Eskimo. Exactly. And why I'm talking this, right? Because at the end of the day, you need to know the why, the what, and the how. Okay. Why, how, and what are you going to do to make the other non-geek guy understand? Okay, now I'm going to give you a small puzzle. Oh, okay, coming back to the main point, let's go back to a basic. How did the term geek come into picture? Who first coined the term geek? Can any one of you tell me? You'll be surprised to hear the term geek came from a carnival. You know carnivals, circuses that used to happen? Back in the time of 1900s. Okay, they coined a term geek to a person who would do something very stupid. And that ranged from falling off of stairs, okay, drinking something that's not supposed to be drunk, and even biting chicken's head off, live stage. Those people were called geek. Now the entire terminology of geek had a paradigm shift. Now we call this kind of guy geek, who has nothing to remotely connected to something as a circus, right? Okay. He still does stupid things. Yeah, exactly. But but he earns way more money than the other guy, right? So yeah, coming back again to the point, right? There is a face hidden over here. Can you find out? Exactly. It, for example, you all know this. It's there in FB. That's why you were able to say this so fast. But why is this important? Among all the coffee beans, right, it is very hard to pinpoint you. If you're making your sales pitch, if you're presenting a new idea to your manager, okay, why will the manager listen to you? At the end of the day, it comes all down to money, how your organization is going to help. It all comes down to this. So if you're going to give him a bunch of numbers, bunch of charts, say this code does this, and even if that code is phenomenal, no one in the world has ever thought of, it's not going to matter to him. What you need to do is build your brand. That is very important. All those pictures of all those people I showed you, they had a brand with them. Okay, when I showed you Bill Gates, Microsoft, immediately, right? Richard Branson, Virgin, immediately, right? Obama, exactly. Obama, US, immediately they carried their brand. When you see that guy, the brand name comes up first and then the guy's name comes up, right? So you have to make your own brand. Okay, this doesn't mean that the manager doesn't have to know you also. So I'll tell you why the managers are also important. Say for example, you have enough money to start your own startup. Okay, you hire 6 people. Okay, you get an option. You can either buy this laptop or you can buy something like this. Which will you go for? Alienware, right? Even if though this, okay, sorry. If at the end of the month, this will be your situation, right? Exactly, right? No more money. So that is why managers are important. They not only manage you, they also manage cost. So don't think too bad about them. They are also important. Okay. I know. So let's see. How are you going to do this? Okay, how are you going to make yourself as a brand? Okay, first, which comes into the picture, is if you're going to stand and talk like this, it's not going to help you. Okay, your manager will be like seeing your watch, okay, how long will this guy take? Exactly, and he'll be least interested. Believe me, he's going to be least, he'll forget you the moment you walk out of the room. On the other hand, if you have someone as confident as him up there, right, you're going to remember him. Even if his sales pitch was not good, even if the guy before him had a better idea, people are going to remember this guy. Okay? Even if this guy costs more money for the organization, people will remember him. Why? That because this man carried his brand with him. Okay? He created a brand value for himself, which the company recognized. And the company said, okay, if he comes, works for us, or if we give him money for his startup, eventually we are going to get benefit. So you're going to work on that. Okay, how are you going to do this? First and foremost is you need to understand why. Okay, why am I going to talk with that guy? Okay, why is it important to talk with that guy? The moment you understand the why, you have a general idea. Okay, say for example, tomorrow I'm going to talk with Obama about Obamacare. Okay, so the moment you understand the why, you have a certain situation. Obama will not come and meet you in a bar. You have to go to the White House. So it has to be a formal approach that you have to take. You have to be good suited, okay? Say for example, you're going to talk with your team lead. Now that happens that, okay, any other day in the office, whatever you are wear in the office, goes in the office. So the moment you understand the why, there are a lot of other aspects that come into the picture. Believe me when I say this, I've seen people come into a presentation not properly shaved, not properly dressed. That doesn't matter. If your presentation also is crap, that guy is lost forever. So the moment you understand the why, you have a plan in the mind, okay? Say for example, give me one more example. Any example, any presentation which you flunked, you know that it went super bad, but you wanted it to go good. Any example? No one? Okay, I'll give you an example. When I started working for my company, we had a huge array of devices. And all of them had local accounts. Okay? So that meant after every 90 day, he had to change the password. Just imagine 20 accounts having 20 different user IDs, 20 different passwords. Huge headache, right? Doable. A quarter down the line, that device from 20 came up to 66. 66 different IDs, 66 different passwords. Now it's getting out of hand. Two solutions came up. There was one guy who said he gave up some huge algorithms, huge details, which the manager didn't understand. I came up and I told him, see, we already use this software. If we buy the license, we integrate with our directory structure. We just change our password once over here. It gets changed in all the devices. Believe me, my idea was shit compared to his, but I didn't throw out to him all the jargon. I didn't throw out to him all the algorithms, where it needed to be installed, how it needed to be maintained. I didn't throw it out. I told him, this is needed, this is there, this is the solution. He said, he paid me money to do it. The other guy's idea was for free. This is where it comes in. Okay, going down. Your venue is also important. Okay, where are you going to meet the guy? Coffee shop? Obviously, you're not going to take your big black, big charts and everything, right? You're meeting at a coffee shop. A tab or a laptop would work just fine. Conference room, maybe you'll bring your laptop, maybe a laser pointer, that's it, right? A huge gallery like this, you're not going to use a laser pointer because the people at the back is not going to see, right? It has to be voice, right? No charts, no nothing. Whatever you're going to present has to be verbal. So your venue also plays a very important role. Your audience, the most important thing. If your audience is like this, you have to keep them interested. You have to keep them interested, otherwise they'll turn out to be this, which you don't want. At the end of the day, you don't want the guys in front of you to sleeping off, to dozing off, you don't want, right? And believe me when I say this, Bill Gates, Steve Jobs, they all practiced. They stood in front of the mirror, practiced 7 times a day, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year on how to present. Because at the end of the day, believe it or not, you're all sales guys. Either you are a professional sales guy or you need to sell yourself, create that brand value. So practice. You know there's a presentation coming up, be it very little. Practice. Once, twice, but practice. Because that is very important. And obviously, you need to remember the central message. You put in so many graphics, so many charts, at the end of the day, you wanted to present about your net sales figure, you end up presenting how the company works. That is crap. So you have to underline the central message. You have to be sure that all your presentation, charts, even if you're speaking verbally, has to go around your central message. Because this is also important. You got that? How are you going to do this? What are you going to do to use this? You're going to use tools. You'll have charts. You have pens. Whoever works in office knows that you can get free office supplies, anything that you want off of the managers if you're going to say, I'm going to give this presentation. Right? Use them. They're not just there to sit on your desk to show, okay, I have this many pens, this many charts, this many colors. No, use them. They're for you to use and to be productive. Your visuals. This is my third time here in Barcamp. I've seen people come up with ideas that were out of the box, crazy ideas. But people actually dozed off in the presentation. They walked out of the room. Because you have to understand, the audience is mixed. You're going to have college guys. You're going to have guys who are genuinely interested in your topic. You're going to have guys who's going to pass the time. And fourth, you're going to have good managers and CEOs might be sitting in the room with you. Okay? So you have to make sure that you have good visuals in your presentations. So the guys are captivated. Say, for example, if you have too many text, the genuinely interested guy will spend 5 minutes just reading through the text and not listening to you because he cannot do 2 things at a time, right? It's impossible for a person to do 2 things at a time. Even computers which say multitasking, very good multitaskers, they have different codes to do that. One core will do one job at a time. It's very impossible for a guy to do two things at a time. What you want to do is have a good visual up and have people listening to you, not looking at your presentation. Okay? Your expression. Except one or two, none of the expression is good during a presentation. Come on. Okay. And say, for example, if I, while I'm presenting, I'm continuously doing this. 10 minutes down the line, your eye is going to be in my hand. You're all going to go like this. Your body language is, again, very important. You need to be sure of yourself. You need to be confident. Okay? And your facial expression. You cannot make weird faces up there. Come on, you're presenting, right? You're creating a brand value for yourself. It has to be perfect. When I say perfect, it doesn't have to be very serious. It shouldn't look like that you're up there going, waiting to go to the loo. Okay? It shouldn't look that you take the entire presentation or conference as a joke. You should be genuinely interested in the topic that you're presenting so that the people in front of you can also relate to you. Okay. So you'll find out that whatever I've said, you have listened to me, not look at the picture. Visual comes into play. And your voice. Standing at the corner, you don't have a mic. Venue, I said, remember? You have a presentation, you find out, oh, fish, the venue is a huge auditorium. There's a small board, and there's one guy sitting 100 feet away. He's not going to see the board. There is no mic, the mic is not working. It's impossible, right? So you have to be sure that your voice comes at par, okay? If there is a 100-foot auditorium and you have to talk, there is no mic, walk around. No one has said that you cannot walk during a presentation. No one has said that when you are talking to someone, you cannot move, you have to be still. No one said, right? So your voice is the key. If it's necessary to walk up to the end of the room to make that guy listen, walk up to the end of the room. Okay? Make sure your voice is always the key. Okay, you have a huge figure, you have a very squeaky voice, I cannot help you with that. Sorry. And last but not the most important, stick to the time. Okay, you have a presentation at 7, be there at 6:45. Okay, set your presentation up, grab everything, have whatever tool that you're going to use. If you're going to use the Wi-Fi, connect over it. If the Wi-Fi doesn't work, make sure that you have a second option. Say, for example, you're going to use the internet to show the guys something. Make sure that you have other options, backup options lined up. And stick to the time. If you're there in time, if you do not waste the other person's time, the other person is going to remind you. He is going to remember you. Okay, even if this guy was crap, he didn't waste my time. He finished it within time, whichever time was allocated. So your time management is also very important. And that's about it. I finished it super fast. Time for feedback. Any feedback? Come on. Anything?
You actually followed yourself. What are you telling? I did observe. We both came very early. And I see you messing around there and setting things up. And it's really relating.
Yeah, because at the end of the day, you want to, whatever product you're going to sell, it also helps to sell if they see that you are using it, right?
Exactly.
You're not going to sell a Ford, and at the same time, you're going to use a Porsche. The guy won't buy you. Come on, right? Yeah. Him first.
And you are seriously, genuinely disinterested in giving the presentation.
That's a very good question. Is the time allocated to you? Is the time, that's one option. But what do you do if there is a conversation that comes in between? So he's genuinely disinterested. He doesn't even see his video. He's sleeping in the corner. The video is he's not interested, right? He's sleeping on the corner, right? Okay, yeah, that's one option. There's one more option. I'm going to ask you one question. Did you fix up the meeting or someone else did?
Obviously, someone else did. It is possible that I might have also.
Yeah.
Because something that I have to do, I don't want to do it.
But at some point of time, there will be something that you have to do because of some commitment. Yeah. Make the most out of it. If you have to present, if you...
Completely disinterested.
I know. If you have, you have to present like a 555 by 555 spreadsheet full of data. Okay. Make a pie chart out of it. That's one line. Right? This is the data, this is the thing, but that's it. You don't
all I'm saying is that see, it's a formality that
yeah.
I have to do.
Yeah.
I have to work up to
it. Yeah.
And I have to spend 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Boring whoever is
to, yeah.
Who is also under here under
the yeah. So okay. The ground is set, right? The guy in front of you is here for formality. You are here because of formality. Take the least amount of time and just give him the data that he wants. Don't go about saying how you got the data, what, which metric you ran, which script you ran, which server has the data, which database is there. Cut out the crap, right? Don't want to spend any time. You're disinterested. You know the other guy is disinterested. 5 minutes. That's it. That's it. Like, okay, this is my server data. This is the company sales. And that's it. Any more information, you reach out to me, I'll email you. End of conversation.
In one case, we have, like I've seen my lead has done the opposite.
Oh, okay. He dropped
the. He sent the data first. He said, please go through this. If you feel the need for discussion, let's meet.
Yeah. A very good example, right? If there was a need for the, that's why that why comes into picture. Do you really need a presentation in the first place? If you do, then go forward. If the guy just wants to ask you some questions, give him the data. If he doesn't understand, fine. We'll take a session, half an hour session, 1 hour session, whatever is needed.
It's tricky because all the stakeholders will be in CC as well.
Exactly.
So if you want it, then you have to tell me that, okay, you want it.
Huh.
If not, I'm assuming that you don't want it.
Exactly. Good point, though. Thanks. Any more questions? Sure. Yeah. 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 If you would have listened carefully, I would have told ki doesn't matter if you comb or anything, your content has to be there. Because if your content is also not good, the other guy is not going to remember you. Yeah, obviously. If you're presenting, you obviously make sure that the content looks good. That's what my first point was. If you have control over the content, make sure it looks good. Okay? Spreadsheets, throw them out. Okay? Just put in a small chart, there are small values, that's it. But important ones. Don't leave them out. Make sure that the important ones goes through. That's it. Any other question? Thanks for the input. Good point, good point. But now tell me this, who were you presenting this to?
This is to my CEO, my company, everybody.
Everybody was? Give me the name of the company, I'd like to work over there. Please.
Is it good or wrong?
Sure. Yeah, that's also important. Yeah. Yeah, but good point. See, I'll again relate back to my presentation. I had a point over there that called audience. You knew your audience, right? Now tell me if it was a client meeting. Where your customers are coming in. Would you have walked in like that?
Actually, I did the same if you don't believe me.
Okay. Okay, then good customers.
Good customers, good luck.
Good, whatever worked for his favor, right? But yeah.
I wonder what Sam
was doing.
Exactly.
Maybe a good song, customer click with it. Yeah, but again, knowing your audience, right? If you know your audience beforehand, you can make your presentation like it. If it's your friend, presentation doesn't matter. Show him the data, that's done. If it's your team lead, technical terms, oh, it's okay. Your lead will understand. If it's your manager, about the technical terms, just show him what you did. This is the login page, and this is how you go in. He doesn't need to know what encryption working behind it. If it's your CEO, show him the front page. Look at this. He doesn't need to know how the login page works. That's the point. So your content varies according to the people you're presenting to, and I never said this is for presentations also. It can be verbal. When you're talking with the guy, your way of talking also changes according to the person you're talking to. Your friend, what's up, and all that. Okay. Your team lead, hey sir, what's up, and your manager, good morning sir. More formal. So as you go up the chain, goes more formal. Right. So again, knowing your audience. Is it very important?
Lots of people are there. Last 2 weeks back, I had to give a demo to around 2,000 people. And then all geek, non-geek managers, CEOs, everybody were there. Then I was like concentrated on the technical side. They said that after the meeting, they said it was a lot of technical stuff. But that was a technical.
I know. I'll tell you one thing. When I joined Texas Instruments, I joined as a security infrastructure. My team lead told me, okay, present to the manager how network file system works. And I showed him how to ping, how to connect, what all options, ops, everything. He came up to me and said, that was the most worst presentation I ever saw. I said, why, sir? The glare of the projector was so much, I couldn't see the guy at the end of it, okay? The manager actually managed to fall asleep in the middle of the presentation. I couldn't see. Okay, I said, oh, shit, I need to go back and change. What did I do? I went back. Again, YouTube, internet, everything is over there. Okay. And I found out that no matter who you're presenting it to, okay, if you cut out that unnecessary text, okay, tell me how much text was over here? But you got the idea? You need to figure out which idea I need to present out. Can it be done in any other way? Might not be text, might not be visual, might be animation. Right? For example, I'll take that present again, that login page. If I made sure, okay, the manager needed to know this, I'll have an animation. How? For example, automated. People typing in some box, something comes up saying AES encryption happening, home page. You presented your idea, right? You showed him that, okay, minimum this much username has to be there, minimum this password, uses AES encryption, okay, and this is the page that comes up, right? That's it. You didn't have to tell him how AES encryption works, what is the algorithm you're using, doesn't matter. Good question, and a very good question. I'm sorry I didn't take backup, as I've said already. There is a website out there that's called Prezi.com. Anyone heard about it? Prezi.com, yeah. Prezi. Okay, you can use it for free, and you can also use the paid version of it. That's totally up to you. Just keep in mind, if you're using the free one, your whatever presentation you made, it's out there it's shared to everyone, it's public. Okay, so it already has built-in transitions, built-in slides, and it's very good. Okay, your 60-year-old boss, when he sees that presentation, he's going to make your son. He's going to make you his son, I'm telling you. The presentations are very good. If you do not have time to make it, go to the website, use it. There also might be other ones which I do not know about.
Those kind of tools can be more interactive. than the usual PowerPoint. It's 60 years old basically. So we have to use, we have to keep moving to the new presentation, you know,
yeah,
tools.
Yeah.
So some
tools. There are loads of tools. Yes.
Have you ever given a presentation over a call?
Over a call. I do it every week.
Yeah.
I do it every week.
So situations, let's say that you've just gotten a hold of a client,
sure,
introducing the company and capabilities, blah, 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 you know.
How would I do it?
Exactly. So what I've noticed is, at least a lot of people do, is that when you're on the call, what you're talking about most of the time is not all that important, right? You're sharing your desktop and a presentation over there. That is where most of the content goes. At least that's what is happening right now.
Exactly.
Reason being,
yeah.
Over here in India, a lot of people do not understand the various accents of clients in the US. Number two is the connectivity might not be that great. The phone that we are using might not be that great, you know?
Yeah.
Speaker distortion and everything.
So
what to do in that case where you have to fill in content in the slide?
Understood.
Even when you use visuals,
understood,
right? Having a 50 slide presentation does not work.
You,
I can't finish it off in 5 slides and give all the information that I want.
Do you know how many slides were here?
I'm sorry, I came in late, but
okay, I went through 31 slides. Did anyone know? No one knew. So that's one point. Amount of slide doesn't matter. Okay. What you said right now is also important, because since it's over phone, visual is important. Because obviously accent barrier comes into play, connectivity comes into play. Exactly. You, expressions is not a thing. So whatever you may be doing, wearing your boxers and having the conversation doesn't matter. So obviously that doesn't. But your visuals, what you said, comes into play. Now coming back to the point, say for example, if you're presenting about your company, okay, what do you need to present? You have to have, make the presentation like this. You have your company logo every time. Okay, that is very important. Okay, give a short background of your company. When I say a short, make it very short. Make sure you have your company picture over and have bullet points, not more than 4 bullet points. Okay, now your company introduction is over. Say you want to highlight some key features of your company. Okay, say for example, SCP Labs have charging points, promotes green, clean energy and all. Make sure you have some pictures relating to that. Okay, so now you have just buttered up your client about your company and why you should go for it. Now coming back to the product that you're going to sell. Okay, now make sure that your slide has your company name and your product name. Okay, so now the now the person knows every time you're going through a slide, he sees the product name also and he sees your customer name also. This is called this is some kind of programming. This is some kind of hacking. It's called social hacking or something. You instill in your customer mind the product name and the company every time. Okay. Description about the product. Again, if you have to write it down text-wise, make sure it is clear and concise. Okay. No algorithms. No pieces of code. No nothing. Tell him this is your product. 5 points. 4 points at max. I believe 4 points is enough. 4 points cover the key features. Believe me, your product, whatever it might be, will not have more than 4 key important features. Okay? Make sure you put it within those 4 key features. That's it. If you want to have pricing and all discussion, I do not know. But try to keep pricing and everything outside of over phone. It has to be face to face.
Is it okay to add testimonials?
When you say testimonials, personal testimonials or company testimonials? Company testimonial. I just told you, right? You have to show how your company, where is it, picture of your company, 4 key points about your company. Who built it, who is the CEO, point of contact that the customer might be interested in. Say, for example, your sales guy, whoever is handling your sales account, the technical guy, whoever handling the product. Make sure this information is over there. The customer doesn't care about testimonials, okay? Because anyway, if you're having a sensitive product, it will be under NDA and you cannot have testimonials outside. Okay?
Okay, one question I wanted to ask. This is for someone, because this is related to branding.
Sure.
This is for someone who does presentations.
Okay.
And we as a startup, because I am a startup.
Good.
we don't get an opportunity to, you know, present it to people or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So how do you actually bring yourself to a brand level that people actually can call you for presentation, or at least make a brand out of yourself first?
Okay.
Because this is one way. Presentation is one way. What are the other ways? Branding again.
Be shameful. Be shameless. Sorry. Be shameless. Whatever you do, make sure whatever your company name be, ABC, make sure it is there. Okay? Your Facebook page should have ABC, not your picture. Not your girlfriend's picture, not your mom's picture. ABC has to be there. Okay? You have a YouTube page. So for example, social media is one of the major key marketing tool out there right now. Okay? Find out which videos go viral. Okay? Related to your product, there will be hundreds of videos which go viral. Say for example, if you're selling a, say you, if your company is a, sells pets online, okay? Sells pets online. Cute doggy photos. Put them in YouTube. Make sure your company name is there. Okay? You'll always have a customer base. You'll always have a user base. Make sure whenever you're doing this, you do not put your name, your found, whatever who are working with, investor, not their name. Your company name has to be there. Okay? That is one of the major important. I've seen people starting up, having their products, everything. At the end of the day, the guy goes back, he's like, shit, he forgot his company name. Goes back to Google and he's typing down his name. Say for example, Anand be the name of the guy, he's typing Anand, there will be Google will return him 50,000 Anands. Right? Make sure whatever you do, your company name has to be there. Your Facebook page, so for example, now if Anand has his Facebook page, his company name, he's like, oh, yeah, yeah, this guy. Might not be that lucky, should have. Okay? I do not have much points, there will be other experts also who have much, much more important points, but be shameless. Okay? If you're giving candy to a kid, my company gave it. Be shameless, seriously. Because at the end of the day, that kid is not going to earn money, you're going to get your bread and butter out of it. Right? Be shameless.
The question also was
I'm not making any political comments. Whatever.
And also the relativity
yeah.
towards connecting your company with some of the social media sites like Twitter, and we have something called Quora.
Okay.
People
yeah.
keep questioning, but they really don't know. Like 100 answers come on and none of them is gonna help us. So if we can pitch into such situations and, you know, answer and relate it to your company or whatever the context of your company, can some or the other guys can think about, okay, yeah, there was one guy who answered that.
If, exactly. Now if you're answering that, if you know that you're giving the right answer,
right.
Make sure that account has your name.
Yes.
It's your
so,
company name, not your name.
Exactly.
If you're in Quora, if you're in Stack Overflow, whatever,
yeah, doesn't matter. So
it's your company name that is there.
Checking the relativity with the context of the question and what you are trying to solve with
exactly.
the company name, then one or the other day they'll remember you and they'll come back.
Thank you for
one of the things. And Twitter, keep tweeting and people
yeah.
people love, there are people dying in Twitter.
Just for example, this guy, IPL. Not IPL, sorry, 2020 World Cup that is happening.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, make sure your Twitter handle has updated scores if you're just starting up.
You know,
people
sir,
people may just follow it just for the sake of the scores, right?
It works very well.
Yeah, exactly. Just make sure you have all the regular. You can write a small Python script that will do that for you.
Okay,
make sure you have all. You need to see which user base. If it's aunties and grandmas you're targeting, obviously Twitter doesn't help that. You need to attack the cooking channel shows and all those kinds.
Daily soaps,
they need to happen. So obviously, keep in mind your user base. You're going to attack the system admins. Okay? Attacking a C++ page or a Java page won't help you. Believe it or me, I do not look up those pages. What I look up are the, for example, Data Quest, PC, Digits, all those magazines, tech magazines that are out there. Make sure you attack the proper base of people. Okay?
As a final point, just be crazy. So be crazy and that people keep talking about you and they just need you. And they either get married or whatever they want to do, just be crazy. That's the only thing that I can say. opinion. Any social media sites, anybody that you're talking to, be crazy enough so that, okay, yeah, they don't forget you. So any jokes that you crack up somewhere, will, okay, when they are in a meeting, okay, yeah, there was one day who, okay, got this point very, okay, somewhat very humorous. So they'll just...
Yeah, I'll relate to that.
But there's a fear to that. So tomorrow, a girl might not marry you.
I really
I'm just being crazy.
Have you seen that movie Guru?
I'm already at risk.
Have you seen that movie Guru? Seen the movie Guru?
Yes.
Seen the movie Guru?
Yeah.
Over there, what did Amitabh Bachchan say? If people are not talking bad about you, you're not getting famous. When you get famous, there will always be two kinds of people. Diehard people following you, diehard people hating you. That's it. All you need to make sure that they know you. That's it. Exactly. Any other questions?
Thank you so much.
No?
Exactly. But sure. I'd just like to add one thing. Just experienced a couple of times that adding element of suspense kind of helps.
That's what I said. It's based on your audience.
Right.
Okay.
No, irrespective of the audience.
If your audience is a CEO, he might not like this suspense.
Okay.
you're saying sales going down, this is going down, and you want to say, okay, right at the end, I'll put my product name and that will help you. He might have a heart attack before he even goes to the So again, I'm not saying that is bad. I'm saying based on the audience. But good point.
Yeah, but you have something to complete. Go ahead. He's giving you an example actually.
Oh, okay.
Now that you want me to give an example.
Go ahead.
Sure.
Okay, off the top of it, again, Steve Jobs. Basically, so every time he presents something, at the end, he says, now one more thing, and then he gives a talk. Example, when he introduced Siri.
Exactly.
So that was like everything he wanted to give was pointing to one thing, which was not revealed till the end.
Good point.
And then that was.
Who was his audience?
Yeah.
It wasn't his investors.
Right?
It was the world who is going to buy the product. You give him that little spark, and then let, oh, and that guy was good. Even if it now. Like cost $25, $100, $200 more, he'll go for that thing. Right? So, yeah.
Sure. Since you spoke about Steve Jobs, I would like to say one point.
Sure.
Yeah. To the presentation.
Sure.
Yeah. So, when he sells, he and Wozniak, when they sell the Apple One, they go to a shop and they say that this is Apple One, take it. Then the guy says, I need a computer.
Yeah.
A mouse, keyboard, blah, blah, blah. You just give this one machine, I don't want that.
Yeah.
Then he says that you have a keyboard in your stores, and you have a mouse, and you have different things which is not in sold out. Why don't you take this machine and you make it a box, big box, and sell it as a computer? He striped it, the machine guy, and he put the order. And when he leaves, the suspense part of it, he says that he never had mind, they never had in their mind about Apple II or something at that point. But he looks back at the shopkeeper and says, I will come up with a new product in another 2 weeks. So that brings up the curiosity in the other guy also, what this guy will come up with. Even though he doesn't have any plan about it, he just put a place that, okay, he should remember me.
And this I'm talking about like the handful of guys who knows how to think on their feet.
Yeah.
Right? Layman guys, like guys, put in a situation I will know, I'll be very scared, right? So that's why where this comes in. So thanks guys. Thanks for joining in.
Thank you so much.